All right, with heart disease, the leading cause of death for American adults, the Cleveland Clinic wants to help clear the air about what we can do to support our heart health.
Today, we're focusing on two topics that you may not have heard before, and to explain them and how to pronounce them, we're going to the expert, Dr. Marc from the Cleveland Clinic. First of all, good morning.
Good morning.
All right, what topics are we talking about? The first one is?
First one is about cholesterol.
Okay.
And the medicine is called bempedoic acid.
Okay.
Okay, now let me stop you there. Statins are usually the go-to, though. Okay,
right.
So this is something fairly new?
It's not a new medicine, but it's a new set of data to show us when to use it. But back to your point, if you have a high cholesterol, statins rule. Statins are the number one medicine for high cholesterol, particularly LDL cholesterol.
And they're found in certain medicines, that kind of thing?
Well, statins are their own medicine.
They're their own medicine.
It's a whole group of medicines.
A group of medicines, okay.
And those medicines, statins, save lives in people with high LDL cholesterol, people who've had heart attacks and strokes and blockages in arteries.
Yeah.
The problem is that some people can't take statins.
Right.
Okay. They don't tolerate them.
So
they
what's
don't, you mean the reaction or something like
that? Yeah, no serious reaction, just they get muscle aches and pains, and it's really bothersome. Not everyone, just some people.
Just some people.
And now this other medicine, bempedoic acid, is an option for people who need a statin but get side effects.
Is it as good, though? I mean, does it do what statins do?
It's not quite as strong a medicine, not quite as effective.
Okay.
But what this study shows, 14,000 people, 7,000 got the medicine, bempedoic acid, 7,000 got a placebo, like a sugar pill.
Okay.
The people who got the medicine had a much lower LDL cholesterol and were less likely to have a heart attack or a stroke.
LDL cholesterol, what are you talking about?
LDL is the bad cholesterol.
That's the bad cholesterol.
So there are a whole bunch of different kinds of cholesterol. Mm-hmm. And if somebody is going to tell you your lipid profile or cholesterol numbers, the one most important is your LDL or bad cholesterol.
Got
that's
it.
The one that causes heart attacks.
Yeah, that's the one that causes heart attacks. Okay.
And this medicine reduces it.
Okay.
All right. And then our second topic today is the erythritol. So I know that a lot of artificial sweeteners, it's widely populated and a lot of people use them.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Stevia and all the other
You've
ones.
You got your
Splenda.
Blue packets, your pink packets, your yellow packets.
They're all on the table at the restaurant.
Right.
So erythritol, I actually never heard of that. So clearly not safe if you're using or?
Not exactly. Erythritol is one of the many artificial sweeteners. It's often used in foods that are recommended on the keto diet.
Okay.
And it's one of these things where you have to look in the list of ingredients to find erythritol.
Okay.
And what did this study find? This study found that people who use more of this particular sweetener were more likely to have heart attacks and strokes down the road.
That's not good.
And these are long-term effects that people aren't long-term. Even aware of.
So what should you look for? I mean, if you use those kind of sweeteners, check the packet, the information?
Check the information, and if you see erythritol, particularly if you already have some heart disease or you're at risk for it, go a different direction. Mm. That study about erythritol isn't the kind of study we discussed with the other medicine. This one was an observational study where they looked at 1,100 people and said, let's see how these people did and how many had a lot of erythritol in the bloodstream.
Okay.
And it turned out the more erythritol you had, the more heart attacks and strokes you had. So it's an association.
Okay. But stevia and Splenda, like the other sweeteners, they're not exactly that good for you either.
Yeah.
Right, so are they kind of in the same category?
As far as we know, they're similar, but not exactly the same.
Okay.
They're all different chemicals. And I'll tell you, there's nothing wrong with natural sweeteners. Like, I think a perfect package is a grape.
Okay.
Made by nature, grapes, fruits, have sugars in them.
Just do that.
And,
don't do the artificial
sugars.
Stuff.
It's the best way to go.
That's a takeaway, basically.
So there you go. Put your strawberries in your coffee.
It's
a new drink.
Don't drink coffee.
It's a new drink.
Don't drink the coffee.
Oh, no. That's a whole other topic.
Another topic. A little coffee's okay.
Here we go.
Thank you, Dr.
Thank you, Dr. Mark.
Appreciate
Always good to see you.